Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, I report on journalism on trial here on the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. We've seen Julian Assange. We've seen Edward Snowden. Both releasing certain information that governments were not happy about anywhere. Julian Assange was put on trial for extradition. He was taken from the Ecuadorian embassy, violating his rights. While he was living at the embassy, he was kept in a small room with no amenities. And he was attacked repeatedly by directed energy assaults, spied on by governments, the CIA of the United States in particular. But let's get into the discussion. Call into the show live and ask a question. Get involved at 800-313-9443, or you can listen at 605-313-0163. And we have Richard from North Carolina with us tonight. How you doing, Richard? You in the green room?
Yes, sir. I'm here, and I'm hanging in there. I don't have a whole lot to be bragging about, but I'm alive, and that's a good thing. Better than Snowden and Assange and some of the other people that have been attacked. These people are probably also being tampered with as far as their minds and their bodies messed with and wreaked havoc upon while they're being held. We have to remember, if we can, and that's a big step for TIs, but a lot of the things we're not remembering are being wiped from our memory, and I would assume that maybe the same goes for any and all the people that are targeted, Assange and Snowden also, and, well, it's a way to bury the truth and keep the truth from coming out, but people here at RBN, that's what we're after, and this is where we can find and handle the truth at RBN. So just keep your chins up and your head down, and let's find some way to work together to try to stop this thing. We may be running out of time. We've got to make some changes as soon as possible.
Thank you, Richard. Okay, the following is taken from activist posts, The Guardian, Reuters, CBS, MSNBC. It's taken from everyone. We've had court hearings in Britain over the U.S. administration's extradition case against Julian Assange. The decade-long saga that brought us to this point should appall anyone who cares about our increasingly fragile freedoms. Journalists being jailed. Journalists forced to exile, like our own Janet Phelan. journalist told to shut up or deal with the consequences. So this is a threat to journalists everywhere. A journalist and publisher has been deprived of his liberty for 10 years. According to UN experts, he has been arbitrarily detained and tortured for much of that time through intense physical confinement and endless psychological pressure. He has been bugged and spied on by the CIA. He gained political asylum in Ecuador's London embassy. This gives him the protection of Ecuador. They cannot, under any condition, let anyone take him from this embassy. As would be the same if someone went to a U.S. embassy and the local authorities tried to break in. That would be met with a threat of war, because this embassy is actually part of the United States, as Ecuador's embassy is part of Ecuador. Great Britain has no right to walk on those premises without their invitation, which they cannot legally give him. There's a judge overseeing his hearings, and he has a serious conflict of interest. With her family embedded in the UK security services that she did not disclose, and she could have recused herself from the case. So, what we have here, what are a journalist's rights in the world? Journalists have walked out in the middle of gunfire with cameras. Journalists have walked into foreign countries risking their lives to get the news, whatever the case may be, to get the news. So we have a journalist who was being drawn and quartered in front of the world. But what the people do not understand is, if anything happens to Mr. Assange, if he goes to prison for 175 years, he is taking with him the rights of all journalists everywhere. Assange is today exactly where he originally predicted he would be if Western governments got their way. What awaits him is extradition to the United States so he can be locked out of sight for the rest of his life. I think there are many more secrets that were not given to the public. There were two goals the US and UK set out to achieve through the visible persecution, confinement, and torture of Assange. Number one, Mr. Assange and WikiLeaks, the transparency organization he co-funded and co-founded, needed to be disabled. Engaging with WikiLeaks had to be made too risky to contemplate for potential whistleblowers. This is why Chelsea Manning, the U.S. soldier who passed on documents relating to U.S. war crimes in Iraq and Afghanistan, for which Assange now faces extradition, was similarly subjected to harsh imprisonment. She later faced punitive daily fines while in jail to pressure her into testifying against Assange. Richard, do you have any comments? Anything you'd like to add?
Oh boy, do I ever! Frank, you're rolling the ball exactly in the right direction with the whole story, because I want to make the American people that are listening or might hear this program to realize this is not about Assange. He should not have to be going through any of the things that he is going through. Well, what it's really about is how much more will the American people sit back and allow the same things to go on over and over without realizing that he was out there on behalf of us. Where are we when he needs us? He needs us now. He needed us a while back. And if he is extradited back into this country, then he should never be allowed to be put anywhere but back to his life and his rights, because that's what they're taking away from all of us. Even as a child, when we were growing up, If someone was doing something to you over and over, even if you got beat up for standing up for your rights, at least you didn't let them get away with it over and over. And most of the time, it would, even if you lost, be understood and taken care of. So he needs us bad, and we need each other even more badly. And we have to realize that we are the ones with the power. It is up to us to make the changes. Please, we have to start, and we should have started yesterday. Thank you.
Thank you, Richard. The aim all along has been to discredit WikiLeaks and similar organizations and stop them from being able to publish more revealing or revelatory documents. documents that show Western governments are not the good guys. Not the good guys managing world affairs for the benefit of mankind, but are in fact highly militarized global bullies advancing the same ruthless colonial policies of war, destruction, and pillage they always pursued, and that we originally left behind in Great Britain. Number two, Mr. Assange had to be made to suffer horribly and in public, to be made an example of, to deter other journalists from ever considering following in his footsteps. He is the modern equivalent of a severed head on a pike displayed at the city gates. Now, I viewed a video the other day of people in Iraq or Afghanistan being gunned down by what sounded like American people in a helicopter. So, what I'm going to say is this. The officer in charge should have been made responsible instead of the person who found out about it. The gentleman in the helicopter chopped down the cherry tree. And now it's time for George Washington to do something about it. We've had it with this. That very video reveals the depth of which people have gone. Now, that was probably the decision of one person. He should have been punished, not Mr. Assange, for finding out. Because if you do that, sooner or later, someone will find out. And when they do, you will pay. They should make a documentary out of that. Okay, we have to go to commercial. Thank you so much. Thank you, Richard.
Folks, we're living in a world the likes of which we've never perceived any clearer than we do now. The plan for global governance has been in the works for generations and would have likely been achieved by now but for the fact that the globalists left open their Achilles heel. With all their tools, Federal Reserve System, fiat currency, no child left behind, and then Common Core education introduced to our schools to dumb us down, vaccines, pharmaceuticals to lobotomize us, GMO foods, insertion of compromised or bought and paid for politicians, judges, mainstream media propaganda, all pieced together like a puzzle designed to ultimately bring the world under submission. But with all their strategy, they forgot one thing: knowledge. And knowledge is power. With knowledge, their bombardment is nullified. Folks, with that, as brilliant and knowledgeable as you've become, among the wisest audience of any radio audience in the world, and you are, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, how much of that knowledge did I obtain from Republic Broadcasting Network? How high has my consciousness been raised since I've been a listener? How fast am I now able to discriminate truth from fake news by being a Republic Broadcasting listener? How clear am I now able to see the world since I've been listening to RBN? Ask yourselves those questions, folks. Then ask yourself, what is that knowledge worth to me? Like my morning coffee, how would I survive without it? A voice of truth in a sea of lies. Do we not all need to make sure it survives? Like public broadcasting, we are now finding we can only survive with listener support. Censorship, advertisers being attacked, truth itself being attacked. It's the only way through this. We at Republic Broadcasting humbly ask you to become a supporter. Look at your budget and make a determination of what Republic Broadcasting is worth to you and what you can afford on a monthly basis. Go to republicbroadcasting.org and pledge 20, 30, 40, 50, if possible, 100 a month or more if it's affordable. Click the donate button and become a regular monthly donor. Assure both us and yourself that Republic Broadcasting truth will continue to flow like that morning coffee. The network thanks you.
Homeowners, are you in foreclosure, expecting to be served with a foreclosure lawsuit, or suspect your lender has coerced you into an illegal mortgage transaction? A huge number of mortgages made in the last 10 years have legal issues and are possibly defective. State laws and the U.S. Supreme Court have upheld that defective mortgage documents are grounds for foreclosure defense and for counterclaims in favor of the homeowner. If your mortgage has been sold or assigned since closing the loan, it may be defective and you may be paying the wrong party, and the lender may not have standing or the right to foreclose or collect payments under the law. If you would like to know if your mortgage is legal or not, or know if you are paying the right party, we can help. Our initial consultations are free of charge. We are not attorneys. We are legal researchers and work closely with experienced lawyers who know how to help you find the evidence to help you keep your home. Call toll free 1-855-2-KEEP-IT. That's 1-855-2-KEEP-IT today.
Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, I report on journalism on trial here on the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. Call into the show live and ask a question and get involved at 800-313-9443. Or listen at 605-313-0163. Okay, we have a caller, Neil from Boston. Go ahead, Neil.
Hey, Frank, how are you?
Very good, sir.
You're lying to me. I'm not very good either. I'm calling in because a thought kind of crossed my mind while I was listening to you earlier, and it's all about, like, long story short, anyone in, like, the truth or movement who's been here for any amount of time at all has heard the words, the Second Amendment is the teeth for the First Amendment. You know what I mean?
Right.
And so what I'm saying is, how did that work out for Australia? Australia, about 20 years ago, gave up their gun rights freely because they got scared into doing so. There was a school shooting of some sort. Everyone gave up their guns. The original Crocodile Dundee died because he wouldn't. And so what happened? So the press, freedom of the press, the press was behind the people giving up their guns. And so fast forward to 2020, and you can't go outside without a mask, without getting, like, choked into prison, getting your new, you know what, kicked by a swarm of cops on the beach in a free country called Australia. Now, I think that if the First Amendment, the press, and that includes everybody, there's nothing in the Constitution that says freedom of the press unless you don't have a degree from Columbia Journalism School or Harvard College or something. Everybody has freedom of the press. Everybody. Period. And we all have to step up, because if we don't step up in the First Amendment, like right now, on the radio, on the interwebs, on Facebook, on TV, the Second Amendment, kiss it goodbye. And once we kiss that goodbye, the United States turns into Australia. And that's what I'm really afraid of, and that's why I picked up this phone, Frank.
Thanks, Neil.
All right?
Yes, sir.
So we, all of us, especially Americans, but I know other people, like, you know, the Irish. I got Irish blood, and believe me, I got Irish. My dad's off the boat. We have to all just not put up with it anymore.
That's what's happening.
And one last thing. In Boston, we're about to hold an illegal eight-ball tournament, a pocket billiards tournament, in a bar in South Boston. And okay, we're doing so mainly to kind of stand up for our rights, but it's gotten to, like, that absurd point where it's like, you know, pool is a crime now. It's a crime. Like, what happened to my free country? It's long gone. So, God bless you, Frank. Keep doing what you're doing. I'm going to hang up the phone now. Before I start swearing.
Okay. Well,
all right, brother.
Yep. I just wanted to
say
one thing. The next time you see a firearm, get up, aim, and shoot somebody, you let me know. Get a video of it.
Oh, no, it's not about that. It's the other way around.
You missed my point.
The people with the badges knock on your door and say you're doing something wrong, and we're going to take you away. Like what they're doing right now in Melbourne, Australia. You know what I mean? That's what I'm, like, freaking out about.
Okay.
And there are so many people who are so brain dead, who are so zombified, that they're just going to go along with it. All right?
Okay. Thanks, Neil. Okay, it's the bottom of the hour. We have to go to station identification. We'll be right back. Thank you.
You are tuned in to the Republic Broadcasting Network. Visit our website by going to republicbroadcasting.org.
Hear ye, hear ye. ConstitutionOnTrial.com presents the most important question for our generation. Is the United States Constitution biblical? Witness the prosecution and defense of the United States Constitution on trial, live and unscripted at the Maranatha Retreat Center in Everton, Missouri, and streamed live on YouTube. For the prosecution, Ted Weiland, pastor, Bible teacher, and author of Bible Law versus the United States Constitution, The Christian Perspective. Versus for the defense, Brent Allen Winters, a practicing lawyer and author of Excellence of Common Law in Light of History, Nature, and Scripture. Is the United States Constitution biblical? Live and unscripted at the Maranatha Retreat Center in Everton, Missouri, and live streamed on YouTube. Saturday, September 19th from 6:30 till 9:30 p.m. Come one, come all. This most important event is free to attend and streamed live on YouTube. Go to ConstitutionOnTrial.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Extendovite really works. Here are some reviews from Amazon.com. John Hess, 5 out of 5 stars. Awesome. Probably my only review, but at age 40, I was getting bad heart throb and left arm pain, mainly before bed. I even stopped smoking and drinking sodas for a month, and that didn't work. After one day of taking Extendivite, it was gone and hasn't returned in 3 years. I've ordered Extendivite 13 times, so Amazon just said. Juliet Hordick. I've ordered this product before in liquid form. It is fantastic. My whole family's been on it. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Is your property a financial burden and causing you grief? Have you tried to sell but can't find buyers? Or are you just too busy to sell your property? Don't worry. We have the right solution for you. We buy properties as is, with cash, close in 30 days, and pay all closing costs. Our service is ideal for property owners who are in pre-foreclosure, have high-end repair costs, experiencing financial hardship, going through costly divorces, are relocating, need cash for retirement, suffering family loss, or have tax liens. Whatever your situation may be, we can help you sell your property and get the money you need. If you own a single-family home or multiple family units, call us for a free consultation at 888-910-1037. That's 888-910-1037. Or visit our website at cashingproperty.com. That's cashingproperty.com. Sell your property fast and leave all your worries behind.
We are coming to you live from the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, I report on journalism on trial. Okay, we have a caller, Mike from Brazil. Go ahead, Mike.
Hi, Frank. How are you doing?
I'm doing fine.
Okay.
How are you doing?
Oh, fine. Okay. I'm calling in response to the last caller you had just before the commercial. And he was saying that the Australians gave up their guns. Well, this gentleman who said that forgets one thing. Australia does not have a Second Amendment right in their constitution. He forgets that. So owning a firearm in any country in the world is not a constitutional right. The only nation in the world that has that constitutional right in the Constitution is the United States, which is why these politicians are going mad trying to find a way to disarm the American people. And they can't, because unless they have a constitutional amendment to do away with the Second Amendment, which is not going to happen, they will never get rid of the guns. And they know that. So this is the reason why they stage all these shootings and trying to get the public opinion swayed towards disarmament, which is not going to happen again, because if you're looking at the statistics, the latest statistics, the gun sales skyrocketed in the last 2 or 3 months. It's like they sold so many guns that it's absolutely incredible. And I try to remind this gentleman that called before that Australia was in no position to refuse the confiscation of the guns, because they do not have a constitutional right to have guns. Like the UK, like every other country in Europe, they have no constitutional right. The only nation on earth, and you can quote me on this, is the United States that has a right etched in the Constitution that gives the people the right to keep and bear arms. Now, the problem is that, of course, like with any other thing, people misuse things, guns, for example. They use them in homicides, they use them in robberies, but you cannot disarm an entire country because of the misdeeds of others. What it would look like to take the right to drive from everybody just because of a few drunk drivers who somehow, you know, kill somebody in the, you know, while driving. So the thing is, no other country in the world is blessed to have such right etched in the Constitution. It's part of our founding document, and nobody's going to take that away from us without a fight. And the people who fired the first shot will be the ones to lose. And we're waiting for that. We're waiting for them to fire the first shot. And I can guarantee you, I was in the military for many, many years in the French Foreign Legion. I took my training there. It gave me a new identity. And I can tell you for sure, do not mess with the American people. We have a lot of people in the U.S. undercover just waiting for somebody to pull the trigger. That's what they're waiting for. They're not going to be the ones to be the first ones to pull the trigger. They're waiting for somebody else to do that. And then all hell is going to break loose. And I tell you something, they will lose because we outnumber them and we outgun them in either way. So with all due respect to this gentleman that called, Australia does not have a right to keep and bear arms. Therefore, the government can do anything they want, just like they did in the UK. And they stage all these shootings. I don't know if you're familiar, Frank, with what happened in Chicago a few months ago, that they discovered crates loaded with weaponry in the back alleys of Chicago's South Side, which is the worst part of Chicago. Okay, and they found crates, literally crates loaded with ammo and guns. Now,
were they Chinese, sir?
Put them there.
Were they Chinese?
I'm sorry?
Chinese weapons?
No, they were just regular weapons, military-style weapons, like AR-15s, AK-47s, you know, you name it. You know, the civilian versions. Of these weapons, not the military versions, but the civilian versions, they're not selective fire. They're just, single shot thing, repeaters. But the thing is, they found crates of weapons in the back alleys. I think it was a couple of months ago, if I'm not wrong. I heard of you on the RBN show, actually, and I think it was... John Stedmiller, who mentioned this, may be him or Mike Rivero. But I did hear this on RBN that they found crates with weapons in the back alleys, okay, of the Chicago's worst neighborhoods you can think of. And I tell you, Chicago is not a place to be around. That's what I can tell you. I've seen Chicago. It's a war zone, okay? So, you walk the streets, and if you get home in one piece, you're lucky, okay? So what I can say is this. Do not blame the poor Australians. Do not blame the poor English people because they had no choice. They do not have a right to have that. So if you have a right, like the freedom of speech, for example, nobody can take it away from you. So regardless of how they deem that freedom of speech to be hateful speech or, you know the game they're playing. So the thing is, if you don't have a right, which is part of the founding document of the nation, which Constitution is the founding document, is the supreme law of the land. Nobody can go over that. Nobody. I don't care if it's Nancy Pelosi or Chuck Schumer or Bill Clinton or Hillary Clinton or Donald Trump. I don't care who it is. Nobody can go over that provision in the Constitution. Okay, it's the Second Amendment, which gives teeth to the rest of the rights. It is the protector of all the rest of the rights in the Constitution. Without the Second Amendment, you don't have any rights. They almost destroyed all of them. Look at the First Amendment. Now, you can't say anything because they'll accuse you of being either anti-Semitic or anti-black or anti-something, right? So the Fourth Amendment is gone. The Patriot Act was enacted. And like Nancy Pelosi said, well, we're going to have to pass it to find out what's in it. Okay, so what kind of government do we have? It's a joke. I mean, you have to pass a law to find out what's in it? What if in that law is a death warrant for the whole nation? Well, you're going to pass it and then find out that you just signed your own death warrant? No, it's ridiculous. So I'm going to close with this, and this is going to have to be a reminder for everybody. The United States is the most blessed nation in the world, not because we have a system of capitalism or we have freedom of speech. It's because we have the freedom to keep and bear arms. This is what distinguishes us from the rest of the world, and this is why they zeroed in on the United States to do away with that thing, and they're trying all kinds of chicanery to try to, you know, they stage all these fake shootings. Well, some of them are not fake, are real. But they're instigated by somebody. Okay, so all I can tell you, Frank, the United States is in dire straits. Well, I can tell you this, because sooner or later something is going to happen. They're going to declare martial law, and they're going to suspend all the constitutional rights, including the Second Amendment, and they're going to go door to door and confiscate weapons. Okay, this is why I'm against registration. Because once you register your firearm, they know what you are, they know who you are, and you know what kind of weapons you have. So they'll go and grab you. They'll go and grab you in the middle of the night. They'll break your door down. They'll send a bunch of SWAT team guys, and they'll break your door down. And if you do anything that even remotely resembles resistance, they'll shoot you. They'll shoot you dead. Believe me, I know a few of these guys, and they have no qualms about it. One of them even said that they'll even shoot a kid if it resists. So this is just to tell you who you're dealing with, okay? So, guys, all of you who have your weapons, keep them oiled, ready, and do not fire the first shot. Let them fire the first shot, okay? And they will be the ones losing. Okay, Frank, and with this, I'll let you go on your show. I'm sure you have another callers online. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you, Mike. I do, but I'm gonna interject something here. In Paris, some years ago, now, there were terrorists and terrorist attacks all over Paris. I'm not going to go into detail, but I'm going to tell you why there were terrorist attacks. Because no one in Paris or France can carry a weapon or own a weapon. So there was no threat of retaliation by a bar owner. In South Boston, you mess with a bar owner, you're in serious trouble. But we also have rights to a militia in this country, and many militia have formed over the years, and they are active now. Okay, Andy from Texas. Go ahead, Andy.
Hey, Frank. Nice to talk to you again. No, I agree with the caller before. I mean, you know, it's awesome that we do have weapons, but here's the sad thing. These people are doing stuff to us right now because they know our weapons are impunity. We're not going to be able to fight back from this. And you know as well as I know that they have direct energy weapons. We've been shooting, like I'm part of it. SpaceX has been shooting up an entire group of satellites. We saw the fires, and just the other night I saw laser weapons being shot down towards fires, and as soon as the laser hits it, the fire explodes even higher and stuff. So these people have, the reason they're doing this, and they know we're armed, if us just being armed would stop them, they wouldn't be doing this. So they found a way around us just being armed. We can't fight back from this in their eyes. Now, I mean, I'm not sure. They lost guerrilla warfare in Afghanistan and in Iraq and stuff. We've been fighting wars where people have fought them with guerrilla warfare and whatnot and taken, you know, got our way with them. But now, I mean, just in the last few months, I mean, during COVID, Mr. Tesla dude, whatever, he's the SpaceX, he shot up a whole bunch of satellites, and they're war satellites. And we saw in the fires last year in California, we saw the blue lasers shooting down. We saw trees. I mean, big fires going on, houses burned up. Cars melted to pieces, but the trees are still standing, so they didn't have the metal particles or whatnot that brought the fires in and stuff. So the reason why they're doing this to us is because they don't believe we can fight our way back out of this. And I think it's very sad for people to think that, you know, it's just a matter of don't make the first shot. I mean, the first shot's already been fired. These people pulled this COVID on us, and you as I and all the people that's been on your show, the targeted individuals, look how they targeted individuals. So they can target a mass amount of people. And when 5G finally gets flowing all the way, they'll be able to target us all. So these people, this isn't a matter of us fighting back. It's a matter of survival at this point, finding a way not to be targeted, not to be a part of the situation that they're pulling us through. But they're making it very impossible. The essential businesses are all the Bilderberg Group people, and I'm sure that's what the Bilderberg Group has been meeting once a year. I'm sure they met more than once, but we always see that specific time of the year that they meet in Virginia or over in Europe or whatnot. These people are meeting, and I'm sure they planned all this stuff, and it got rid of all the mom-and-pop stores, all the middle-class stores, all the independent stores. And the only essential workers are going to be the people that will play along with this, which are the Bilderberg Group, the Walmarts, the Targets, the Best Buys, the Firestones, you know, all these big name products and stuff. They're going to be the ones that actually bring all this in. You won't be able to go in there unless you have a mask. Now, mom and pops might let you in without a mask, but these stores won't. And then eventually it'll be you can't come in here without a vaccine. All the mom-and-pop stores would let you in without a vaccine, but they're not there anymore. They killed the middle class. They've destroyed it. They've gotten rid of it. There's simply nobody left to actually let us do commerce, and that's exactly what they wanted, and I'm pretty sure that's exactly what the Bilderberg Group's been talking about for years. So having said that, we're just trying to survive here, and I think it's going to get tons worse. Now, I'd also like to mention something that people might not, they need to go to the UN website because there's a lot of insight in there. First off, they've got a virtual reality concert there that talks about a new world order behind closed doors. We will rise again. We will rise again. They're talking about the Phoenix, and this is all relative to earlier times in the world. But they also stated that this year is going to be the darkest winter ever. And I don't know what that means other than the fact that they're going to shut the power off, which means that we're all going to freeze. And they also have this geoengineering going on, the fires going on. What was that big storm that walked through Iowa and destroyed 10 million acres of corn? I mean, that's never been done before, and it missed the news. The mainstream media got a little brief on there, but, I mean, we lost tons of corn there. There's derailments of corn. They've been blowing up industries all around, plastic industries. They've destroyed corn silos. I mean, they're getting rid of our food supply. They're getting rid of everything. This is depopulation, and I think the American needs to wake up to this. This has been in their books for years. Look at Henry Kissinger's writings. Look at Alex Crowley. Look at all these different people from the past. They've all written about getting rid of people. They've decided that they need to depopulate us. And I think with this targeted individual stuff, I think that was test running, how they could target individuals. And they're going to target people.
Yes, we have to go to commercial, sir. And if you'd like to hang on, that's fine, too. Thank you so much.
Hello, I'm Dr. Leonard Horowitz. I was right 30 years ago in warning the world about threatening lab virus outbreaks, AIDS, and Ebola. I was right 20 years ago when FBI Director Robert Mueller made me a suspect in the anthrax mailings because I warned the Bureau before the CIA's biocrime and Cipro sales psyops happened. I was right about COVID-19 being an AIDS-laced mutagen plan to resurge this fall to excuse officials' profitable depopulation globalization agendas. And I was right about the only safeguards being antioxidants and holy spiritual sustenance. Vitamin C, D, zinc, chlorophyll, oxygen, and oxysilver especially transmits the frequency resonance to neutralize the expanded function bioweapon. Oxysilver is a double superconductor of the healing power of love. It is the first nutraceutical invented to amplify prayer power and the faithful, loving intention of your heart. Buy, try, and stockpile OxySilver through HealthyWorldStore.com.
Homeowners, if your lender has gone out of business or sold your transaction to another lender or servicer, you may be the victim of a wrongful foreclosure resulting in the loss of your home. If you've already lost your home, are in foreclosure, or even in good standing, you can challenge the mortgage transaction's illegal issue and your property can be restored to you, and your foreclosure can be stopped or reversed and the mortgage transaction declared unenforceable. State laws, U.S. title codes, the Uniform Commercial Codes, and U.S. Supreme Court rulings have upheld that defective mortgage documentations can reverse or stop foreclosures and enforce property title claims in favor of the homeowner. We are having successes in stopping the process of foreclosure, the enforcement of the foreclosure judgments, the sale of property, and evictions after the sale. We are not attorneys, and we don't give legal advice. We are a professional team of legal researchers, providing forensic mortgage audits and expert witnesses. We have the knowledge to produce the evidence and enforce laws regarding your legal issues. We've been in business for 12 years without a complaint. Consultations are free, and we provide a free title search to confirm if your mortgage has legal defects. Please call 855-253-3748. 855-2-KEEP-IT today.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
After about a month of Extendovite, I don't know what it is about the circulation factor. I was able to increase the weight, increase the amount of sets I could do. It has to do with the oxygen getting to the blood. You should market this as an athletic performance. And I don't change anything about my diet or anything. I just thought, this is amazing. Bilberry extract has got something called resveratrol in it, which is the same stuff that you get from red wine. It's also good for eyesight. And I was reading that the Royal Air Force during World War II would give their pilots bilberry jam so they could have better night vision stuff. This is amazing.
To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Let him tell what you really feel. Teach the children quietly for someday sons and daughters will rise up and fight while we stand still. Can you hear me?
Welcome back. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, we have been reporting on journalism on trial here on the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. I'd like to say one thing referencing the Second Amendment. And that is the fact that if you took the weapons away from the people of the United States, you want to see some terrorist attacks? This is a big country. There would be terrorist attacks on every major city. Big terrorist attacks. Okay, Richard, you want to give your closing few points?
Oh, absolutely. Oh, and I'll get back to Assange, and what that's about is our rights, not just his. And our rights came into place after the gun came into place, and the people have used weapons from the beginning of time to secure their freedom and their lives with sticks and stones or whatever they could pick up. We're not going to freeze to death We've been keeping our buns warm since the beginning of time. So, you know, the thing is we have a battle to go at, and the guns and the Constitution is about our freedom. Without the guns, we're going to lose the freedoms. But even with sticks and stones, there's no way that they could win. Absolutely not. And, well, you have to kind of figure that this is all about tyranny, and that's been around for a long time, too. So Australia, without their guns, could not maintain what freedom they had with or without a constitution, and that's the only way you maintain freedom is with war. Freedom is not free. It has to be paid for. Ours has been paid for. But it's not something that continues on without maintaining the freedom. So, you know, wishful thoughts and theories and thinking of all these things does not come down, as Frank says, to the militia, the Minutemen, and the people of this country that would stand up against terrorism and the removal of their freedom. But if they get away with Assange, they're going to get away with the next thing and the next thing and the next thing. Somewhere along the way, we have to draw a line. Thank you, Frank.
Thank you, Richard. Well, it's the top of the hour, and I would like to say good night from Boston, Massachusetts. God bless you all.
What would you say if I told you we have a new tool that will increase production and lower maintenance costs for your meat processing company, and it would pay for itself in just 6 weeks?
When pigs fly!
The new Ease-Off Model EZ4 replaces old spring-style carcass droppers and is faster, safer, and more reliable. The Ease-Off lowers or lifts 1,000 pounds to or from your rail automatically using our remote control.
Sounds expensive! Can I afford it?
Can you afford not to try the Ease-Off? It installs fast with just 3 bolts in place of your current dropper. The effortless operation will reduce fatigue and injuries, speed up your line, eliminate downtime, and increase profit.
How can I order my Ease-Off?
Go to easeoff.com, EAZEOFF.com, and hurry, because we are offering $200 off on the new EZ4 for a limited time. Easeoff.com. We make pigs fly. Cows, too. Ease-Off LLC, Summersville, Missouri, 417-932-6419.
This is RBN, the Republic Broadcasting Network.